Welcome my dear friends and students. In today's video I am going to explain the two instruments which are used to measure the pressure. So that's why right here we have to discuss the topic measurement of pressure by considering the two instruments. The first one is the mercury barometer and second one is open tube manometer. So first of all let us consider mercury barometer. Now here the mercury barometer is the simple instrument which is used to measure the atmospheric pressure. So that's why I write the first point as an instrument used to measure the atmospheric pressure is called barometer. Secondly, now this barometer consists of one glass tube. So this is a tube whose one end is closed and other end is open. In that tube you have to take the mercury. So that's why I write here the second point, that is it is in the form of glass tube filled with the mercury. This is the glass tube filled with the mercury. And now you have to place this glass tube in an inverted fashion in another container or dish which also contain the same liquid, that is the mercury. So this is the here glass tube. Now you have to put that glass tube in a inverted fashion in such a way that its closed end, that is in upper side, and open end, that is deep, in a mercury. So that's why I write here that tube place upside down, it means in a inverted fashion, in a small dish. That small dish also contain the same liquid, that is the mercury. Now this tube having particular dimension whose length is 1 meter and diameter is 1 centimeter. So that's why I write the third point, a glass tube of 1 meter in length and 1 centimeter in diameter filled with the mercury up to its rim. And then you have to quickly invert that tube, glass tube, in a dish containing mercury. Now what happened? As the open end is inside the mercury or this dish, some of the mercury inside the glass tube that will be moved outside the dish. That's why right here it is then quickly inverted in a dish containing mercury. The level of this mercury, now see here, initially this glass tube is completely filled with the mercury. When it is inverted in the dish containing mercury, some of the mercury in this space, that is move outside. That's why we have here a empty region. So that's why right here the level of mercury in a glass tube lowers as some of the mercury spill in a dish. Now a gap is produced between this closed end of the tube and the surface. Now this empty or gap, empty space or gap, that is called as the toxin, is vacuum. It means there is no medium present in that small gap. That's why it is called as toxin is vacuum. Now here you have to consider the point in that gap. So as there is no particular medium above that point, that's why pressure at that point is equal to zero, because the pressure of vacuum or vacuum pressure is always equal to zero. Now here you have to create or consider the two points. The first point B, which is inside the glass tube, and second point C, which is outside the glass tube, that is in a dish, but where on the surface, free surface of the mercury in such a way that the level of B and C, that is same. What we consider here, let us quickly revise it. We have to discuss here the mercury barometer. This is the instrument which is used to measure the atmospheric pressure. It consists of simply a glass tube containing mercury. Then that glass tube is placed in an inverted fashion in another vessel, that is a small dish containing again the mercury. When this glass tube is kept in an inverted fashion in a dish, some of the mercury in that glass tube that will be moved outside, giving us the small gap. That small gap where there is no medium. That's why it is called as the vacuum and given the name as Torsielli's vacuum. Now you have to consider some points. Consider the point A, which is just on the free surface of the mercury inside the glass tube. Consider the second point B, which is inside the glass tube but at certain depth, that is at a depth H. Then consider the point C, which is outside that tube but at a same level as that of the B. Now here let us consider the three points, that is point A, point B and point C. Now point A is on the free surface of mercury but inside that tube, glass tube. The point B is inside the glass tube but at certain depth, that is the H. And C is the point which is on the free surface of mercury, that is outside the tube, that is in a that small dish. So that's I write here the pressure at upper end of mercury column inside the tube is equal to zero. Why? Because above that point A there is no medium, that is there is a vacuum, and all of you know that vacuum pressure is equal to zero. So that's why pressure at point A is equal to zero. Now here we consider the two points, point C and point B. So that's why right here consider the point C on the surface of mercury in a dish and other point B inside the glass tube, but how? At the same horizontal level. Now here the pressure at C is equal to the atmospheric pressure. Pressure at this point C is the atmospheric pressure because it is open to the atmosphere. That's why right here the pressure at point C is equal to the atmospheric pressure as it is open to the atmosphere. And as both are the points B and C that are at the same horizontal level, so as we discussed earlier, pressure is same at different points which are at the same horizontal level. That's why right here pressure at B equal to pressure at C. Now here consider this point B, which is at a depth H. Then we can have the pressure at point B, which is at a depth H from this point A. That pressure is given by pressure at B equal to pressure at A plus H rho G, where H is the depth of that point from the point A, rho is the density of mercury and G is the acceleration due to gravity. So as we consider here, this is the point which is in a vacuum. That's why pressure at A, that is equal to zero. So that's why right here pressure at A equal to zero. Hence pressure at B equal to what? H rho G, where H that is found to be 76 centimeter. When this experiment performed, it is found that the level of mercury inside the glass tube is more than the level of mercury in a dish, that is more than 76 centimeter. Here now if we consider the three values, that is height equal to 76 centimeter or 76 into 10 to the power minus 2 meter, Density of mercury 13,600 kg per meter cube and acceleration due to gravity 9.8 meter per second square. If we put all these values, then it is found that the atmospheric pressure 1.013 into 10 to the power 5 Newton per meter square. So that is the atmospheric pressure we determine here with the help of this simple instrument called as the mercury barometer. Let us consider the second instrument to measure the pressure, that is the open tube manometer. Now this open tube manometer simply consists of a U-shaped tube. So that's why right here the first point, a manometer consists of U-shaped tube which is partially filled with the low density liquid. Here we have to select such a liquid whose density is less, like water or kerosene. Now why we have to select? Why we have to select liquid of low density? The answer is given in a second point. We have to select the liquid of low density to help the level difference in a two arms of a that U-shaped tube. So that's why right here this help in having a large level difference between the level of liquid in two arms. That is, this is the first arm of U-tube. This is the second arm of U-tube of a manometer. Now in open tube manometer, one of the arm is open to the atmosphere and to the other arm we have to connect the other container which contains certain gas. Now here the pressure, you have to consider again three points, point A, point B and point C. As this is the point on free surface of the here low density liquid, consider the liquid inside the U tube manometer, that is the water. So this is the point which is on the free surface of water. As this point is open to the atmosphere, so that's why pressure at point A is equal to atmospheric pressure. So that's why right here pressure at point A is atmospheric pressure, as this arm is open to the atmosphere. Now we have to find the pressure at this point. We have to find the pressure at this point because of whatever the gas present in this container. The gas which is present in that container, that will exert the pressure here. And we have to measure that pressure with the help of this instrument. So that's why to find the pressure at point C, which is exposed to the pressure of gas. Now consider the two points, point C and point B, as these are the two points which are at the same horizontal level. That's why we can write as pressure at C equal to pressure at B. So let us revise these points quickly. Now we are discussing here the open tube manometer which consists of simply U-tube. Now when we consider only the U-tube and some low density liquid is taken in it, then here initially the liquid level in both arms, that is same. Why? Because both the ends that are open to the atmosphere. But when one of the end is connected to the container, another container containing the certain gas. Now here a manometer consists of this U-shaped tube containing some liquid like water and kerosene whose density that will be less. We select such a liquid in order to have the larger level difference. Here the liquid level in one arm is this, and liquid level in another arm like this. So that is the level difference between the two arms. So that's why we have a greater level difference just by selecting the liquid having low density liquid. Then in third case, now in open tube manometer, the one arm is open to atmosphere and other arm is connected to the container, that is the D, which contains certain gas. Now you have to consider the pressure at A. Now consider the pressure at B and C, both are at the same horizontal level. Now to find pressure at A, that is equal to the atmospheric pressure because it is open to the atmosphere. And these two points are at the same level. That's why we write here pressure at C equal to pressure at B. Now here consider this point and we have to consider the pressure at this point B. So this is the point which is at a depth H from this point A. So we can write the pressure at point B is equal to pressure at point A plus, that is the H rho G, that is atmospheric pressure. So here consider pressure at point B equal to pressure at point C because both are at same level. So that's why right here pressure at point C equal to, that is here pressure at A is the atmospheric pressure and H rho G, that is the pressure at this point because of the here weight of the liquid column, which is H rho G. So pressure at C equal to pressure at D according to Pascal law. Whatever the pressure transfer from point D to point C, that is the same. So that's why I write here pressure at C equal to pressure at D. So let us consider that pressure at point C and D, which is equal to P. So here I write here pressure at C or pressure at D equal to P. I transfer this pressure, that is the atmospheric pressure. So pressure at point C minus here atmospheric pressure equal to H rho G. Again by putting the same values, that is the height means the level difference here, then density of the liquid which is taken into consideration and G is the acceleration due to gravity. By putting these three values, we can easily find out the pressure exerted here because of the gas. So this is how we can easily describe the two instruments which measure the pressure. The first one is a mercury barometer and second one is a open tube manometer.